They excite you when you see them and carry you on their shoulders for an easy win. Welcome to my top 10 favorite hard carry items in the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth. Before I get to the list, I'd like to take a moment to mention that this list is comprised of my own personal opinion and should not be taken as actual fact. As with any video like this one, there's bound to be disagreements. The items on this list were ranked with my own personal playstyle in mind, and I encourage players to discover and experiment with their own favorite items in the game. By my definition, a hard carry item is an item that has the ability to win a run on its own. This top 10 list was based around the premise of the listed items being your only item on any particular run. Again, I know there's going to be some disagreements, so feel free to post them in the comment section below. Now with that being said, let's get started. Kicking things off is number 10, Maw of the Void. When it comes to hard carry items in Isaac, you'd be forgiven for not remembering Maw of the Void. One of the better new items released in Afterbirth, Maw of the Void has everything you'd expect from a hard carry item. It's got damage, great synergies with many different items, as well as the ability to produce black soul hearts when killing enemies. Due to its versatility, damage, and support-like properties, Maw of the Void is a solid pick as my 10th favorite hard carry item in the Binding of Isaac. Number 9, Mega Blast. I had a very difficult time including a spacebar item in this list, but if I had to pick just one, it's gotta be Mega Blast. After you unlock this item by beating Mega Satan with every character, you're rewarded with hands down the most powerful spacebar item in the entire game. Mega Blast simply obliterates everything, including bosses, and is even powerful enough to propel Isaac through multiple rooms. Although its charge-up time is long, its extended duration more than makes up for that, and its sheer power is good enough to land it in the number 9 spot on my list. Number 8, Tech X. Of all the new items introduced in Afterbirth, Tech X immediately made a name for itself due to the incredible amount of synergies it supported, but even by itself it remains a powerful hard carry item. Tech X can be fired in rapid succession or charged up for large room-sized shots that pierce and travel through anything in its path. Tech X also benefits from tier upgrades and can easily destroy every enemy in the entire game. You'd think that the benefits would end there, but Tech X also shares the added benefit of its lower cousin Tech Point 5 in its ability to not interrupt the charges of other items such as Mom's Knife. All of its great power on its own, Tech X is a solid pick at the number 8 position on my list. Number 7, Dr. Fetus. There are very few items in the game that can generate as much excitement as Dr. Fetus, but every time you see it, you know you're in for a fun run. Dr. Fetus replaces Isaac's tears with bombs that deal massive amounts of damage to anything in its blast zone, including Isaac himself. Dr. Fetus was originally bugged in the released version of Rebirth, but it was finally fixed in Afterbirth to deal that classic Dr. Fetus damage we all knew and loved from the original Binding of Isaac. Even though Dr. Fetus is powerful enough to win a run on its own, it would be very remiss of me to not mention all the potential synergies that Dr. Fetus works with. One of the most exciting and surprising things in Rebirth was the fact that Dr. Fetus now shared synergies with many different items out there, and not just bomb-related ones either. Given the Afterbirth damage buff and the benefit of having limitless bombs and excitement on a run, Dr. Fetus explodes on my list at number 7. Coming in at number 6, Ipecac. Although it may seem a little unwieldy at first, Ipecac's power to blast away anything in only a few shots more than makes up for it, and generally means you're in for a smooth and easy win. It's also worth mentioning that Ipecac has the potential to synergize with more items in the game than almost any other item on this list, and even though it didn't factor into my final ranking, it's definitely worth mentioning nonetheless. That being said though, Ipecac can be its own worst enemy at times, given the fact that, like Dr. Fetus, Isaac can actually damage himself if he's not careful with his shots. However, the fact that Ipecac one-shots most non-champion mobs in the game and can easily destroy all but the toughest of bosses in a few seconds, its danger factor isn't enough to drop it any lower than the number 6 spot on my list. Number 5, Epic Fetus. This will probably be one of the more debated rankings on the list, but Epic Fetus definitely deserves a spot in the top 5 of my list due to it being the very embodiment of a hard carry item. It's got more power than Dr. Fetus and can usually be safer to use than Ipecac. Epic Fetus turns Isaac tears into guided missiles that vaporize everything it lands on, and it can easily win runs on its own. Once Rebirth came out, most players were shocked and surprised to see that Epic Fetus was given synergies unlike its original Isaac counterpart that virtually had no synergies and overrode every item in the game. The potential synergy theories had players drooling at the idea of the possibilities, and Epic Fetus makes good on pretty much all of them. As with Dr. Fetus and Ipecac though, it is worth mentioning that Isaac can damage himself if he's not careful with his shots, and Epic Fetus can end a run as quickly as can carry a run. While not my favorite item in the game, I do feel that it would be disingenuous to rank it any lower than number 5. Coming in at number 4 is Sacred Heart. There's a general philosophy in the gaming world that if an item is super rare, it better be worth it, and Sacred Heart definitely fits that bill. On top of the massive damage increase that Isaac receives when picking it up, Sacred Heart also combines the homing properties of Spoonbender right out of the gate, giving it defensive bonuses to Isaac when swarmed by fast-moving enemies. The only downside to Sacred Heart is the fact that it's one of the rarest items in the entire Isaac franchise, and I personally have only seen it in the wild a handful of times. Still, if asked the question, would you rather have Epic Fetus or Sacred Heart, I would choose Sacred Heart 100% of the time, and that fact alone is good enough to place it above Epic Fetus in the number 4 position. Before we get to my top 3 favorite hard carry items, I recently posted a video asking fans to post their own top 3 picks, and the response was huge. After tallying up all the nominations from hundreds of different responses, the audience poll for overall top 3 favorite hard carry items had a 2-way tie between Godhead and TechX for the number 3 spot. The number 2 spot goes to Brimstone, and the overall number 1 favorite hard carry item in the Binding of Isaac goes to Mom's Knife. Honorable mentions also go to Epic Fetus, Ipecac, Sacred Heart, the D100, and Glitter Bombs. Thank you to everybody who did respond on the video with your responses, and keep an eye out for more audience polls as the Top 10 series progresses. Kicking off my top 3 and matching the audience polls number 3 is Godhead. It takes a lot to convince someone that there exists an item even rarer than Sacred Heart, but Godhead would be it. On top of the outrageously difficult path to unlocking it, Godhead wears the title of rarest item in the entire game, but if you're just lucky enough, you may find yourself giddy with excitement when you do finally encounter it. On the surface, Godhead doesn't seem all that special. It has the homing properties of Sacred Heart and adds a cool glow to Isaac's tears, but is generally underwhelming to look at, until you see the damage that the aura that surrounds Isaac's tears does. Godhead is a powerhouse item that completely shreds anything that the deadly aura touches, and can easily take down even the toughest of bosses. Although it does take a little getting used to the idea of not aiming your tears directly at enemies, once you do finally grasp controlling the shots and using the aura, any player will fall in love with Godhead and instantly wish they saw it a lot more frequently. If given a choice, I would easily take Godhead over Sacred Heart, which is why it coasts its way to number 3 on my list. Number 2, Mom's Knife. Of all the hard carry items in the Isaac franchise, Mom's Knife is arguably the item that appears more often than most other items on this list. Although technically not the only melee item in the game, Mom's Knife reigns as the supreme melee item with its massive damage and fantastic range. Even at its most basic, unmodified level, Mom's Knife can easily one-shot pretty much every enemy in Isaac's way and completely delete bosses in a few short seconds while in melee range. On top of its incredible melee damage, Mom's Knife can also be charged to attack from great distances, pierce through enemies, and even ignore environmental obstacles like rocks and mushrooms. It does it all. It's also worth mentioning that Rebirth and Afterbirth added some unexpected synergies with Mom's Knife, namely Inner Eye, also known as Triple Shot, and Mutant Spider, also known as Quad Shot, giving it even more of a reason to land at or near the top of anyone's top 10 list. Still, there remains one item that I personally like even more than Mom's Knife. Coming in at number 1 is Brimstone. Brimstone is hands down my personal favorite item in the entire game and arguably the most popular item in the franchise. From the moment you see it on an item pedestal or in a devil deal, you know your run is going to be taken care of. Brimstone boasts the most potential synergies out of any other hard carry item in the game and has the wow factor to impress even the most cynical of its critics. If I was only given the choice of one item to win a run on, Brimstone would easily be my go-to pick 100% of the time. It has infinite range, pierces all obstacles in the game, fantastic damage, and shows up just often enough to keep you excited every time you see it. Granted, it doesn't have the most damage compared to other items in this list, but it makes up for that with its range, which allows players to safely destroy entire rooms without even needing to see the enemies. In almost every situation, Brimstone is a must-have for any run, especially when you take the sheer amount of synergies it shares with other items. And though that fact ultimately didn't factor into my ranking, none of my fans will be surprised to see that my overall favorite number one item in the entire Isaac franchise is also my number one favorite hard carry item in the game. In my personal opinion, there's no better item to carry your run than Brimstone. So there it is, my own personal top 10 favorite hard carry items in the Binding of Isaac. Thank you to everybody who responded to the audience poll for participating, and if you have your own idea for my next top 10 video, post it in the comments section below. Also, feel free to let me know what your own top 10 list would be for this video or any of the other top 10 videos on the channel. I'd love to read them. Thank you very much for watching, and as always, I will see you all in the next video. Until then, so long, everybody!